Well, the economic challenges, of course, have been worsened by the global coronavirus pandemic. The effects have been felt across all sectors, including our institutions of higher learning. The University of Pretoria Vice Chancellor, Professor Tawana Kupe, is warning that large-scale retrenchments and even insolvencies at university are possible because of COVID-19. Well, he joins us now. Professor, good evening to you. Thanks very much indeed for your time tonight. We've seen cities losing revenue, tax revenues are down by 300 billion rand. Do we know yet how much revenue universities have lost?
No, I think we're still counting because, as you know, the coronavirus is not yet over. We're still incurring costs in relation to the rolling of opening of universities at each level. We also have had to divert funding towards PPEs and health regulations. And remember, also, the public is struggling to pay fees. And so most universities have staggered payment regimes. So, for example, in September at my university, we expect some payments. Payments have been very slow at this moment. But you expect, because the public is also under pressure because of job losses and related factors, that you would not be able to get the fees that you would get and that the student debt will rise.
I imagine you've also had to lay out money for online education. Not all of your lecturers and learners would have been ready for it.
Yes, absolutely, yes. We've had to online learning has initial very expensive costs. Many universities have had to buy laptops. We bought laptops for our students. I must say also, yes, the government has come to the party for NEFSA students, for example. They're going to outlay funding for that. And also they've tried to negotiate on behalf of universities with the telecommunications companies for data. So that is a great help. But still, it leaves a big hole in the finances of both the universities and the government because these are unanticipated costs caused by the pandemic.
So what's going to happen? I mean, if you retrench workers, you have less capacity. Beginning of next year, we have more students still wanting to come in to institutions of higher education. Maybe NISFAS helps them. I mean, we're looking at quite a difficult situation.
Yeah, it will not necessarily follow. The statement I was making is that the costs could lead to this kind of situation. So we need to all manage costs in a particular kind of way. Our first response, I can tell you, that is not to retrench people because we need the capacities, especially for academics. So what it means is that actually we might need in the budgeting for 2021 a specific stimulus package for universities in order for them to keep the capacities that are needed, not just to educate students, but to carry out some of the research that we have been carrying out in towards actually addressing the COVID pandemic. So that capacity is necessary. So I'm not saying therefore it's inevitable it will follow, but I'm saying that it could follow given the economic impact on all sectors, and we are not an exception.
I mean, the long-term impact of that is really bad. We're a country that really needs to invest more in research. Research, as we found during the pandemic, is really important to a society.
Absolutely. I mean, the one thing that's interesting, Stephen, in this pandemic, not just South African universities, but African universities in general, for the first time, universities have come to the party in a big way with research and interventions from vaccine trials to manufacturing sanitizers, manufacturing varieties of PPE equipment using 3D printing. That means universities are critical to ensuring we create the kind of health system that next time there's a pandemic, we don't have to do hard lockdowns, which then impact on the economy. So hence my plea and our plea as the university sector to say, invest some in a stimulus package to keep the universities, because they are important not only for preventing situations like we face now, they are key to regenerating the economy and reimagining South Africa as they also reimagine themselves. So critically, if there are critical sectors to invest in going forward to recover from COVID-19, universities are key to that. They've shown that they can, with more investment, they can even do much more. And long-term investment in health and long-term investment in human resource development, which is what we really do, is going to be critical to a recovery of the economy, recreating the economy, reimagining the economy and a new South Africa and Africa.
Professor Tawana Kupe, do appreciate the time. Thanks very much indeed. He's Vice Chancellor at the University of Pretoria.